景色が 確か。日差しにやられたようだな。少し休んで体を冷やした方がいい。私の家がこの近くだから。
午前授業なのに、女二人でお茶なんて寂しいね。ま、私も人のこと言えないけどさ。学生飲みで異性と交際するなんて、ハレンチだわ。下手ね、お得意のハレンチ。ああ、そうよ、トシ。この店で、ゆうきとデートしたことあんだよね。
え、ゆうきくんと？冷たくて気持ちいい。
今日は暑かったからな。私もすぐに行くから待っていてくれ。はい。綺麗な人。ドライヤーはそこにある。ところがちょっとだけヤミさんに似てるかも。
すみません、何から何まで。九条凛だ。あ、私結城みかんです。結城リトの。
あ、妹だろ、覚えてるよ。九条凛、確か。
あの、今日は添乗員さんたちと一緒じゃなかったんですか。咲様はお父上と食事の予定があってね。綾も私も別行動さ。
もっと楽にしていいよ。ああ、でも、すみません、失礼します。君はしっかりしているな。兄とは大違いだ。あの男と来たら、ことあるごとに私や咲様に猥褻な行為を。近づくだけで危険な男だ。
先日も転倒して、私、すまない。妹の君に話すことではないな。いえ、事実ですし。家ではどうなんだ、あの男。そりゃもうダメな兄ですよ。あいつ私がいないと何もできないし。最近は、そうでもないかもしれないけど、私がいなくても。
どうかしたのか？
ゆうきくんとデートって。前にさ、ナンパ男から助けて。野獣！ま、男なんてみんな同じ。エッチなことばっか考えてんだよね。ゆうきだって、所詮ただの男ってやつ？
なるほどな。居候が家のことを手伝うのは正しいことだと思うが、君はそれで自分の居場所をなくしたように感じているのか。ももさん、園芸の話もゲームの話も私よりリトと趣味が合うみたいだし、なんだか私立場なくて。君は慕っているんだな、ゆうきりと。別にそんなんじゃないですよ。
ただ妹として気にしてるだけで。
私にはフラチモノにしか見えないあの男も、君にとっては違うらしい。
大丈夫。もう元気だって。
本当か？無理してないだろうな。
してないよ。大声出さないで、恥ずかしい。 見せつけてくれちゃって。それにしても九条凛さん、チェックしておこうかしら。
どうかした？小手川。
別に。
これが初恋の相手だなんて。
何するのよハレッチ
ナ。私絶対認めないんだから。
So, episode 8, Bad Mood. That was a really good episode. It was interesting that Momo wouldn't kiss Rito, especially considering the fact that she's trying so hard to go ahead and get closer to him. And it seems like she actually cares about him. Even when it came down to Mikan, when she was like, oh yeah, I'm jealous of you, Mikan, and I... because you have this connection with Rito that nobody else has. It seems like she actually really does genuinely care about him. So she's not just using him to, you know, as a way to feel her own pleasure or get at her sister or anything like that. But yeah, it was interesting that she wouldn't kiss Rito. She was like, maybe when you're awake or anything like that. So she is a pervert. She's just not a molester or anything like that. But I enjoyed how we got a chance to see a little bit more when it came down to Mikan, see how she feels replaced or see how she feels kind of useless on the team, because she's so used to going ahead and taking care of her brother and taking care of everybody else and everything like that, to the point where when she can't do that, I guess it kind of seems like it's a bad move on her part, in a sense. But yeah. Let's see, what else do I have written down here? Ren. I thought that was pretty cool how she ended up going ahead and taking care of her, getting her shower and everything like that, and helping her out. Because she looked like she was about to fucking pass out. That's not summer heat. You don't want to be playing around with that shit. Which is kind of interesting because right now it's the summer, so. And I thought it was interesting that Kotegawa, she knows Rito a lot. When old girl was like, oh yeah, Rito and me were trying to get Rito, whatever like that, and he's just like, he's a man, so of course he would do something like that. But she was like, no, he's nothing like that. She should know, because she's been in that situation where he could have done something and he chose not to. So it's like, she knows how he is already. So she's had firsthand experience on knowing how he is, that he wouldn't do something like that. Also, I thought it was interesting that that Momo said that that was flight gear that her sister developed. Huh. I don't know why I always thought that they just grew wings out of their back, like any other anime. They actually didn't even need to explain that, because I just basically fully accepted that that was just something that they, I guess the Devil Nukes could do, but apparently no, that's actually just a maneuver gear that Lala developed that they actually use, that grows wings for them and helps them fly. That's pretty interesting. As I said, when it comes down to it, you forget sometimes that that Lala is that fucking intelligent. And Haruna seemed like she took a kind of backseat as well. Like she's now a side character at the moment. I guess because this is mainly about Yami Darkness is mainly about her, to where they're not going ahead and focusing on Lala or Haruna and everything like that. It's more about Darkness and Momo and how she feels, and how Mia and Nana kind of tie in all together. So it's mainly focusing on those characters, because this is what this part of the series is. which is interesting because this seems like the most structured of all the other sections or versions of the series, to where it's more streamlined, to where you can go ahead and make your own hypothesis and think about what might end up happening. But it, and you have those type of suspicions of what's going on. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed my reaction. If you did, be sure to hit the thumbs up button, subscribe down below for more videos just like this one. Make sure you like me, love me, and talk to me down below. I'm gonna see you guys in the next video. Peace.